What does Mrityu mean? Again, why does he use the word Mrityu? Remember, he doesn't say Yama Moksha. He says Mrityu Moksha. Yama is not Mrityu. The two should not be confused. Shiva is actually Mrityu. When does death happen? Death happens when Shiva comes for you. The Kundalini is so happy to see him that it jumps out of your body, you are dead. Yama is the first human being who died. He is responsible for allotting karma. After you die, then he decides. So he is the judge of men's karma. He is not the lord of death. This is one of the biggest misunderstandings of the culture. Shiva actually is death. And we are saying, Ma Mrityunjaya, and we are worshipping the person who causes the... But what does it mean to die? What does it mean, Mrityu hone se, what does it mean? It means that your 70-80 years of personality that you have accumulated, you can no longer hold on to it. The body is tired of you, your mind is tired of you. Yeah, you are tired of living, and so you drop it. It means boundaries, bandhan start dissolving.
Why there is a Shiva temple in a crematorium?
For the same reason. Because the boundary is dissolved. And because he is the actual lord of death. You die when your kundalini leaves you. Till your kundalini leaves you, you don't die. Your body can be shattered into 1,000 pieces, but you won't die. See, that lady who used to come for meditation, her karma is all burnt up. So there is no way that she can maintain conscious, waking consciousness and waking functionality. So she had the stroke. But death is not yet happening because still the kundalini is... Her kundalini was very strong. That's why all the karma burnt up. No? Now, because she didn't have the people to give the right advice, they didn't know the tricks to keep her in the body. Okay, multiple reasons. But when death happens, it means that all the limitations that we take for granted and call a life, main is sharir se tang aa gaya hoon, main is zindagi se tang aa gaya hoon. What are we saying? We are saying we are feeling cramped. We are saying we are feeling limited, bandhan. Ultimate bandhan kya hai? Annamaya kosha. You are praying to the lord of death. You are telling to Rudra, the guy with no limitation. And the rishi is Markandeya, who is outside time also. you want to be in the world, you have to be in time. Yes, in manifestation. You are praying to the fellow who's outside time, and you're saying this is going to heal you?
But for remedies in astrology books, they say 1 lakh.
They don't know anything. Yeah. They don't know anything. You're asking a stupid question like this, Ram. After all that I've said, you're asking a stupid question. Mrityur Moksha. What does Moksha mean? Again, he has not said Brahmagyan, he has not said Jivan Mukta, he has said Mrityur Moksha. See, these words are part of our culture, that is the problem, nobody thinks of them. Mrityu means there is one fellow sitting on a buffalo, big black fellow with a gada, and he will do with big moustaches, and he'll come and it's the culture. And what actually happens, what yogis actually know, what rishis actually know, nobody is interested. So the word Mrityu is completely misunderstood. Mrityu is not even Yama, you know, here is the clearest. Yama is the restrainer. Because he allots your karma, he creates your boundary, he creates your bandhan. Usiliye unko yam kehte hain. Wo aapke karma ko limit karta hai. He limits you, he limits your karma. He limits your potential. Shiva is the one who says, all right, we can open you out. Yama is the limiter. Because if all your karma is released simultaneously, you will fry on the spot. And then there is more karma to deal with. So, he gives it to you in 60, 70, 80 year packets that you can deal with. This mantra frees you. This mantra opens you from your limitations of gender, your limitations of name, country, age. It is a, that is moksha. Moksha is that complete finish of all karma. If there is no karma, there is no limitation. Moksha, of course, means that you become enlightened. You've burnt up all your karma. Now, very often people become enlightened, but they are not yet moksha prapt nahi hota hai. Because residual karma is left. Moksha basically means karma no longer functions. So in that sense it is correct. The story of Shiva fighting with Yama and kicking him away is correct because Yama is limitation. Limitation is karmic. Shiva comes to remove your karmic limitation. From death lead me to immortality. It's not so simple. It's not so simple that from death lead me to immortality. If you die, you are no longer having any limitation. Achha, you want to get moksha? All right. Many yogis say, achha, you want moksha? I'll give it to you right now. You'll have to die. Is that okay? Even in all our Puranic stories, whenever there is an avatar or, you know, Durga fights somebody, Kali fights somebody, Shiva fights somebody, that asura is given moksha. How are they given moksha? They kill them, yes? So where does it mean that mrityur moksha means liberation from death? It can probably mean liberation through death. In the whole culture, the way moksha prapti, yes? God comes and kicks your ass, that is when you get moksha, yes? This is what I am saying. People just don't look at the words. They don't look at the context. They don't look at what is being communicated. Because the human body is a limitation as it is currently constituted. People like Aurobindo and all are working to make it into a more energy-based body, you know, so that then we can live 400, 500, 600 years old, you know, and without all these limitations, without all this wear and tear, without all this old age and senility and all our affirmations, basically.